हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द प्रज्ञान पब्लिक स्कूल जेवर। आई एम मिस सेजल सिंह एंड टुडे आई हैव टेकन द टॉपिक फॉर यू एंड दैट इज सब्जेक्ट एंड प्रेडिकेट। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल द क्वेश्चन अराइजेज इन आवर माइंड दैट व्हाट इज सब्जेक्ट एंड व्हाट इज प्रेडिकेट एंड व्हाट आर देयर यूजेस, व्हाई वी हैव टू लर्न दिस। सो वी आर हैविंग द आंसर ऑफ दिस क्वेश्चन स्टूडेंट्स। Subject and predicate. A sentence has two parts, a subject and a predicate. So now we understand that yes, subject and predicate, there are two parts of the sentences, but what are they and how we use them? Let's see. Subject is the naming part of a sentence. It tells who or what the sentence is about. Okay, so now subject is the naming part. It means we can also call it noun, we can also call it a pronoun, we can also call it a name of any person, place or thing. Yeah, right. So subject, it tells who means person or what means which thing the sentence is about. Okay, so about whom we are writing that sentence, it depends on the subject. And what about the predicate? It tells what the subject does. It is the action part of the sentence. If the subject is the naming part of the sentence, then predicate is the action part of the sentence. So it tells us that what action that subject has done. What action should be done by the subject. So it means it is giving us the information about the action. Subject. In short, who or what the sentence is about. We are having the example Sara plays. So Sara, here we are getting the answer of the question who. And if there is one anything, then we are getting the answer of what. So now we can take one example of predicate. As we all know, predicate tells us what the subject is doing. So the example is here, Greg writes. Okay, so Greg is the person, and what action he is doing? Writing, of the writing. So Greg writes. So here writes is the predicate. And here Sara is the subject, and place we can call it a predicate. Now what is a subject? I hope that you all very well aware of the Spider-Man, what he was doing and what he is doing in the story. Try to understand, you will get your answers. So subject. The subject of a sentence is simply what or whom the sentence is about. It usually comes before the predicate. So obviously, the subject of a sentence is simply what or whom the sentence is about. It means the name of a person, place or thing. It usually comes before the predicate. It means it comes before the action word. It means it comes before the verb. So we can also say that our sentence is starting with the subject. So see here. The examples are also given. A can of lima beans sits on the shelf. The verb sits agrees with the subject can, not with beans. Now here see the second example. The women who went to the meeting were bored. The verb were agrees with the subject women, not with the meeting. So by this we are able to understand what are our subjects. Let's see about the simple subject. So what is a simple subject? A simple subject is a noun or topic without any modifiers or description. Okay, so obviously in simple subject, we are not having much things to be confused. It is simply a noun or a topic without any modifier. The example is given here, the apple. So the apple is our simple subject. Now we can talk about the second type, that is the complete subject. A complete subject is a subject with modifiers and adjectives. Okay, so complete, by the complete subject, by the name itself, by the heading itself, we are able to understand that here we are talking about the subject which is already complete, which is giving us the complete sense. So here the subject is complete. How we can see by the example. The shiny red apple was bitten and tossed. So here you are able to see there are some adjectives, there are some modifiers with apple. Apple, if you remember, which we have used in our simple subject example. So what additional things we have added here? Shiny red. Okay, the is here and apple is here. If we have used the apple was bitten and tossed, so it will be the example of simple subject. But when we are using and adding shiny red, the adjective and the modifier before the noun, before the apple, before the subject, it becomes the complete subject. Now it's time to learn about the compound subject. When a sentence has more than one subject, it can be noted that it has a compound subject. Okay, so we have to learn from this that when any sentence has one or more subject, it can be known as the compound subject. As you all know, compound is the thing which is made up of more than one thing. So the compound subject is the subject in which there are one or more subjects, means more than one subjects are used. Examples are here: zombies and vampires are monsters. So here zombies is also a subject, vampires is also a subject, but we have used here and we have used two subjects, zombies and vampires, and we considered that both are the monsters. Okay, so zombies and vampires are monsters. So here we have used more than one subject, so that is the compound subject. And you are also able to understand by the conjunction and we have used here, which is the coordinate, or we can say which makes the compound sentence. Right, students? So now it's a time to test yourself. See, in the next slide, there are four pictures. Write three sentences in regard to the four pictures in the next slide. The first sentence should be a simple subject sentence from that picture. The second sentence should be a complete subject based on that picture. The third sentence should be a compound subject based on that picture. It means in all three of examples, you have to cover all three types of subjects. And here is your quiz. Here are your pictures on basis of which you have to create the sentences and you have to give the examples of all three types of subjects: simple, complete and compound subjects. Okay, so now this is the turn to learn about the predicate. The predicate is a part of a sentence that says something about the subject. The main part of the predicate is verb. As we all know, action words. So predicate action word hona zaruri hai. So it means verb hona zaruri hai, kyunki verb usme main part hota hai, kyunki verb hi hame action ke bare mein batata hai, verb hi action word hota hai. The predicate usually comes after the subject. Obviously we are also aware of the subject verb object format of English, in which subject always comes first, then verb, then object. So the predicate usually comes after the subject. Just ask yourself what the sentence is telling you about the subject. I came, I saw, I conquered. Ask yourself, you will get your answers. Now it's time to understand about the simple predicate. So what is simple predicate? A simple predicate is the action of the subject. Simple action we have to just describe in our predicate action we have to tell. So the zombie runs. So here runs is our simple predicate. Now complete predicate. The complete predicate is the verb and all its modifiers in a sentence. Okay, so a complete predicate is a verb because here we are also having the modifiers in a sentence. So it clears us more and it makes a complete and more meaningful sentence. So here is the example. Someone was attacked yesterday by a zombie. Okay, so attacked here is a verb, right? And we are having the more description about this sentence. We are having the modifiers in this sentence. So that's the complete sentence, complete predicate. Now we have to understand about the compound predicate. So when a sentence subject has more than one action, it is referred to as a compound predicate, as we have learnt about the compound subject in which we were having more than one subject. Like that, in compound predicate we are having more than one action, so it is referred to as a compound predicate. So see here, the zombie runs after a person and rips into their flesh. Okay, so here in the example also, the zombie runs after a person and rips into their flesh. So runs and rips, two actions we are included in the simple in this single sentence, and which makes this sentence a compound predicate. So now this is the time to for the quiz. What you have to do, you have to write a three lines beginning with a simple subject and a simple predicate. The second line will be a sentence of a complete subject and a complete predicate. The third line will be a sentence containing a compound subject and a predicate. Feel free to search online for 2 minutes to find a picture to use as a prompt. So, all the best for your test. Thank you so much. This is the subject and predicate video. I will meet you soon with another video. Till then, do practice, keep practicing. Have a good day.